Hello, my fellow creators. Welcome back to Mods on Media. Today, I wanted to show you this Luminar AI tutorial on how to use the clone tool. So in Luminar, if you scroll down to the professional section here, you're gonna see the clone tool right under Dodge and Burn. Typically, you're going to use this to, let's say, remove blemishes like on this image. So as you see here, I already have an image selected. So the way this works is if you see on the screen here, it says click to set the source. What Luminar is asking you to do is, what is the area you want to sample? So for example, let's say I wanted to remove this pimple here. The first thing I'm going to do actually here under the clone settings is to set the radius roughly around the size of the blemish or just slightly bigger. In this case, I'll leave it at 35. The softness, it really depends on what you're doing, but I tend to keep it around 20 or 30 just because you want the same texture of the skin and you don't want it too soft. And the opacity, I tend to leave it between 20 to 40. I'll try 30 at this point because you don't want to be too aggressive using it and you want to cover it up gradually. So as you see here now, this is the sample cursor. So what you do is click Alt and click your mouse button and it's going to start sampling from that spot. So as I brush over this, I'm going to brush it really slowly in an upwards motion and you see that blemish is gone. Now you see a little bit of remnants of it still, so I'm gonna click another spot close to it. I'm gonna resample, click in this spot and brush over that area. So it looks now as if that pimple wasn't even there. So I'm going to do the same thing. And the trick with cloning is you want to find textures that will look like, you know, what it's supposed to look like. So obviously, if I clicked on the hairs here, it's going to duplicate the hair. It's going to clone the hairs there. And that's not what I want to do, right? If I were to sample here, I'm going to click very close to it. Alt click and then brush over the blemish. So I'll continue to repeat this process until I'm happy with the results I'm getting. Now this is something you have to really take your time with. This is not something to rush. If you want it to look seamless, if you want it to look natural, it's always best to take your time with it. And also you don't want to use a big brush because you're going to be covering too much area. And again, you want to make this very subtle. The shortcut key to increase or decrease the size of the brush is the bracket keys. So I'm just pressing the bracket keys here to increase and decrease the size. So there's a before and after. So I hope that was helpful for you guys. In the next video, we're gonna take a closer look at the portrait editor. It's something that I use quite often because most of the work I do outside of YouTube is, you know, pictures of people with artists and musicians. And I use the portrait editor a lot for those types of projects. Now in the meantime, if you haven't checked out this video yet, be sure to check it out after this video. It's about masking and it's one of my most used techniques that I've been using for since I started photo editing really. And masking is a good way to achieve certain results you want and manipulating foreground, background, doing selective coloring, all that type of thing. So make sure to check it out, and yeah, we'll see you then.